In this video, we will discuss the concepts of direct proportion and inverse proportion. In the picture shown in the screen, there is a cow grazing in the ground. We know that one cow has four legs. If there were two cows, the number of total legs would be 8, isn't it? Similarly, if there were three cows, total legs would be 12, and so on. Here we see that as the number of cows increases, the total number of legs also increases in such a manner that the ratio of number of cows to the number of legs remains constant. We say that the number of cows and total number of legs are in direct proportion. Let's write the number of cows with letter X and total number of legs by letter Y. Then we can say that X is in direct proportion with Y. It is represented as X directly proportional to Y. In such case, there is always a constant number K such that X is equal to KY or X by Y is equal to K. If X1, X2, X3, etc. are values of X and Y1, Y2, Y3, etc. are values of Y corresponding to value of X, then we can write X1 by Y1 is equal to X2 by Y2 is equal to X3 by Y3 and so on, which is equal to K. Can you give some examples of direct proportion? Think about it. Let me tell you, the speed is constant. The distance is directly proportional to speed of the car. The perimeter of square is directly proportional to length of the side. Similarly, if length of the rectangle is constant, its area is directly proportional to the breadth of the rectangle. Can we say the cost of things and number of things are in direct proportion? Discuss this with your friends. Now, consider a different situation. Suppose there is a tank in the ground which contains water for the cows. The tank contains a fixed amount of water, say 300 liters. If there is only one cow, then water available for cow will be 300 liters. Suppose there were two cows, will the same amount of water be available for each cow? No. Now, water available for each cow will be half of total water, that is 150 liter. If there are three cows, then water available for each cow will be 300 by 3, that is 100 liter, and so on. We see that as the number of cow increases, water available for each cow decreases in such a manner that the product of cows and water available for each cow remains constant and is equal to total amount of water in the tank. We say that the numbers of cows are inversely proportional to the water available for each cow. Let's write the number of cows with letter X and water available for each cow by Y. Then we can say that X is in inverse proportion with Y. It is represented as X inversely proportional to 1 by Y. In such case, there is always a constant number K such that XY is equal to K. If X1, X2, X3, etc. are values of X and Y1, Y2, Y3, etc. are values of Y corresponding to values of X, then we can write X1, Y1 is equal to X2, Y2 is equal to X3, Y3 and so on, which is equal to K. Can you give some examples of inverse proportion? Think about it. Let me tell you, the speed of car is inversely proportional to time taken by the car for covering a certain distance. If the area of the rectangle is constant, then length of the rectangle is inversely proportional to the breadth of the rectangle. Can you tell me whether the number of men and number of days required to complete a certain work will be in inverse proportion or direct proportion? Discuss with your friends. I hope you understood the concept very well. Thanks for watching this video.